Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I have another When Beauty Turns Ugly for you today. I'm going to do my skincare routine whilst talking about a beauty story topic event. Today's all about weight loss, and I don't know about you, but I've definitely tried my fair share of diet fads, weight loss fads, from exercising trends to like alternative weight loss kind of procedures. I've tried everything from electro-muscle stimulation, caffeine pills, the cabbage soup diet, and even that lemonade diet that Beyonce made famous. And I say that cringing and not with any kind of pride, because honestly, the only time I've ever lost weight and kept it off is with good diet and exercise, you know, the good old fashioned route. But you know, some of these weight loss fads and procedures work better than others. There has been some more modern kind of standout procedures that have become extremely popular because you do get very, very good results in a minimal amount of time. Procedures that have little to no downtime, procedures that are non-surgical, really non-invasive. And one of the most popular fat removal procedures nowadays is Cool Sculpting, where they literally freeze away your fat. So, skincare routine. I've already cleansed the Ordinary Glycolipid Cream Cleanser. This is so nice. I'm liking the direction the Ordinary are going in at the moment. I went off them because everything just felt so harsh and strong. Whereas this is so gentle. It's like you're cleansing with a moisturizer. It's so nice. I'm just going to rehydrate my Glow Recipe Waterman and Glow Ultra Fine Mist. It's hydrating and smells like watermelon. It's great, love it. So Cool Sculpting was created by Zeltic Aesthetics, formerly known as Juniper Medical, founded in 2005. And they basically made cryolipolysis, aka fat freezing, mainstream. I'm just going to go in with an essence. This is the Miguhara Vegan Skin Relief Soothing Essencer. What it says on the bottle, really, it's nice and soothing and hydrating. Really nicely fragranced. If you don't like fragrance, you won't like this at all. So fat freezing was really kind of discovered by a Dr. Dieter Manstein and Dr. R. Rox Anderson of the Wellman Center for Photomedicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. And they also taught at Harvard Medical School. So their work was based on something called the popsicle paniculitis theory, which is the idea that you can lose weight in your cheeks by sucking on a popsicle or ice lolly, as we call it here in the UK. They then took that theory, kind of froze fat, got rid of it, and then invented the fat freezing machine, which they later called Cool Sculpting. And this generates more than $2 billion in revenue as of last year, as of 2022, even after the story I'm about to tell you today. So how does this FDA cleared procedure actually work? So according to the Cool Sculpting website, the non-surgical Cool Sculpting treatment is FDA cleared to reduce stubborn fat in 9 different parts of the body. Cool Sculpting technology works by applying targeted cooling to fat cells, triggering cell death. Frozen fat cells in the treated area will begin to be eliminated in the weeks following treatments by the body's own natural processes. There is no harm done to surrounding nerves or skin. The result, up to 20 to 25 fat layer reduction in the treated area. Best of all, they say, once the treated fat cells are eliminated from the body, they are gone for good, or with little to no downtime and no surgery. So how do they become so popular? Because they are wildly popular nowadays. And like all these beauty trends we've seen, it's really down to like a peak in celebrity interest. So the Kardashians were rumored to have had this done to their bodies at the height of their popularity. But it's also the fact that finally this non-invasive surgery that was kind of like liposuction, which everybody knew what liposuction was, without having to have that thing shoved in you, without having to be open up and surgicaled on. You can have it done, carry on with your life, and lose weight. Now, to be honest, I have looked into Cool Sculpting before, and I've had a look at a lot of people's like personal journeys, sponsored and non-sponsored by Cool Sculpting. And they often show their like before and afters. It's usually around 6 weeks to 2 months kind of timeline. And don't get me wrong, they look great. But when I look at their before and afters, I'm like, you can achieve this with exercise and a good diet. Because once you have Cool Sculpting, don't get me wrong, you have to eat healthy. The fat's gonna go, but you have to maintain your weight. It's not meant to completely rid you of fat that you carry on life as usual. But saying that, people often get this done in those 9 areas that Cool Sculpting has been approved for because they are stubborn areas where, you know, people struggle to lose weight. Their stomach, the little pooch at the front, the double chin, which is definitely where I struggle. No matter what weight I am, I still have this pocket of fat. The bingo wings, the inner thighs, this under bra area here, you know, where you get these little pockets of fat. These are areas where, like, even if you work out every day, they're really hard to shift. So I understand fully wanting a helping hand in those areas. In fact, I've had Kybella done before. And Kybella is almost the same thing, but it's like an injection. It basically burns away the fat. And again, it's one of those things where once it's gone, you have to kind of keep the weight off. And I didn't, just because of my lifestyle. I wasn't exercising, I wasn't eating well. And it just kind of, I never feel like it went, but it definitely came back. Do you know what I mean? So it wasn't successful for me, but I get wanting to have those hard to kind of like get rid of areas done. Okay, next up, I'm gonna use a serum. This is the Tiny Associates Boosting Molecules Face Serum. This is such a nice hydrating serum, but also helps with skin tone and texture. Very lightweight, watery kind of texture, a little bit sticky, but as always with every cosmetic procedure, there's a slim chance, according to the brands, that something could go wrong or you're not going to get the results you expected or are promised. And a Cool Sculpting appointment did go horribly wrong, and unfortunately for Cool Sculpting, it was on a very public figure. It's August 2015. Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg actually announced that for the first time ever, 1 billion people logged into Facebook in one day. Remember Facebook? I don't use it anymore. And the Muppets Miss Piggy and Kermit the Frog took to Twitter to announce their breakup. Sad day. Why didn't no one talk about that? It was also the month that Canadian icon, supermodel of the world, Linda Evangelista, who was once given the name most photographed woman in the world, had her first Cool Sculpting appointment. Linda Evangelista, I'm going to tell you something that's going to make me sound like an idiot now. I used to think it was Linda of Angelisa. And I was like, where's Angelista then? Like, where's that in the world? And what is she, like a dame or like a princess or a queen or something? I was such an idiot. This was years ago when I was like 15. I know who she is now. She was considered one of the top 5 supermodels during the time when supermodels were the biggest celebrities in the world. You know, we're talking like late 80s to like late 90s. Naomi Campbell, Kate Moss, Linda Evangelista, the other ones. And she was one of the highest paid models. She was actually rumored to be paid $20,000 to walk a single catwalk, which at the time in 1991 was an extortionate amount of money to pay a model. Nowadays, that's what most influencers charge for a product review, you know? But back in the day, it was huge. It was huge. In fact, she claims that she coined the phrase, I won't get out of bed for less than $10,000. You know, that kind of, I won't get out of bed kind of thing. But she also played a huge part in getting models a fair and higher pay. She helped and still helps raise awareness and money for a number of AIDS charities. She's a huge advocate for LGBTQ plus rights. She even has her own star on the Canadian Walk of Fame, which is a thing. I didn't know that was a thing, but good for her. She is all over a major, huge piece of pop culture. So let's go back to her Cool Sculpting appointment and what happened. It wasn't very good. So back in August 2015, when Evangelista was 49-ish, she was having her first Cool Sculpting appointments, and then she had 6 more appointments leading up to February of 2016. She learned about Cool Sculpting through direct advertising and through word of mouth from friends and family. Oh, I'm using the Dew Skin Oracle Reviving Eye Gel, one of my favorite eye creams. Very good for kind of like helping volume under the eye, hydration, and ridding of any kind of like bumpy texture. I'm putting on very lightly, as you see, because I'm going to use the limited edition free gift eye mask. I saw that they were doing these. No! I saw that they were doing these on the website, and I was like, I have to order more eye cream so I can get these. These are reusable eye patches that, with the help of product, kind of stick on under your eyes, create this layer. Oh, that's sticking so good. They create this layer that kind of trap everything and help your product work better. And then they just kind of like help diminish dark circles, help with volume under the eyes. I love them so, so much. You just wash these with like a cleanser. Evangelista wanted to target a few hard to budge areas of fat. She was very active. She had a great diet. You know, she is still a model. She was living an active, healthy lifestyle because it's her job to, basically. She was targeting her chin, her thighs, again, that bra area around it. I don't know the actual name for it, but they call it bra area. But started to notice that only 3 months after her appointment, she was getting kind of like these odd kind of like bulges of fat, she presumed, in those areas. And she recently had an interview with People magazine, and she said that she thought these bulges were her fault. She had her Cool Sculpting appointments in those targeted areas, and fat was building up there. So she thought that she wasn't dieting enough. She thought she wasn't exercising enough. You know, she wasn't sticking to the advice that the Cool Sculpting team had given her. She started excessively dieting, excessively exercising. It even got to a point where she was starving herself because these fat pockets weren't budging at all. Now, it wasn't until June of 2016, a few months after her last Cool Sculpting appointment, that she finally went to the doctor because she knew something wasn't quite right. And after talking about the Cool Sculpting appointments, the doctor had diagnosed her with paradoxical adipose hyperplasia. Basically, this is a side effect of Cool Sculpting. A side effect of Cool Sculpting that Evangelista wasn't made aware of, not even when she was signing all these important documents before her appointments. The side effects, according to the company themselves, only affects 1% of patients. And this is where, instead of freezing the fat away, it actually does the opposite. The fat gets thicker and expands, leaving you with what looks like these pockets of fat that unfortunately you can't actually get rid of. Now, because this wasn't made clear to Evangelista through any of her consultations, we can definitely feel a lawsuit brewing. And it was, you know, quite an intense lawsuit, but very quickly kind of sorted. We'll get to that. Let's look at the actual lawsuit, because there was a little bit more interesting. I always find the lawyers are like incredibly like sassy for like, you know, businessmen. So let's look at the lawsuit here. Linda Evangelista versus Celtic Aesthetics. I think I'm saying that right. So she is suing the makers of the Cool Sculpting tools and procedure itself, not the place where she had it done. She is represented by Rawbull Markham LLP. This has been their most notable case, and she is suing for damages of $50 million. And listen, the preliminary statement is really good. Like, it's good. Let's read it. Evangelista's lawyers state, Miss Evangelista is an original 90s era supermodel and is one of the most recognizable and photographed women in the world. Yes. Miss Evangelista's quality of life, her career, and her body, however, were all ruined in 2016 after she was permanently disfigured as a result of using Celtic's Cool Sculpting system, as well as the multiple procedures and surgeries required to try and correct those physical injuries. We'll talk about that in a bit, because it's actually Celtic that suggested she get these further operations and procedures. Celtic created, designed, developed, manufactured, distributed, marketed, promoted, and directly advertised its Cool Sculpting system to consumers, including Miss Evangelista, as a safe and effective way, non-invasive alternative to liposuction surgery. Celtic, however, failed to adequately warn and or intentionally concealed the incidence and occurrence of known serious adverse effects, including, but not limited to, paradoxical adipose hyperplasia. We're going to call it PAH from now on. This product's liability action seeks recovery for Miss Evangelista's severe and permanent personal injuries and disfigurement, her pain and suffering, severe emotional distress and mental anguish, and the economic losses that she sustained as a result of being rendered unemployable and unable to earn an income as a model, all of which said damages were inflicted upon her by Celtic. The lawsuit goes on to then actually question the professionalism and capability of the employees doing the Cool Sculpting appointment and the kind of people that they hire in general. They say that Celtic has awarded several non-medical professionals a Cool Sculpting University master's and expressly allows and encourages the non-medical professionals to market themselves as Cool Sculpting master specialists to the general public. They go on to say that they didn't warn Miss Evangelista of any known risk of developing PHA as a result of using the Cool Sculpting system. And they also go on to mention that the consent forms that you're always given before you get Botox, filler, a chemical peel, Cool Sculpting, in their opinion, didn't actually adequately enough explain the risks of Cool Sculpting at all. They say that it kind of just like overly casually stated that there is very unlikely and a very small possibility of anything happening. Basically saying it's unlikely, but there is a small chance that fat will grow instead of going away. Which is definitely undermining the fact that if that does happen, you're going to have surgery, this fat will never go away. It's kind of undermining how serious the risks are, really, and how life-changing these risks are, how financially ruining the risk can be as well. So once Linda Evangelista was diagnosed with PHA, she got in touch with Celtic and was like, this is what happened. How are you going to fix it? My words, not hers. And they said, look, go in for corrective liposuction surgery. We will pay for it. We'll pay for it. We'll pay for all the damages. So she was like, okay, fine. Went for her consultations. They actually went to a surgeon that Zeltic recommended themselves, a surgeon that they use specifically for when any of their customers, when any of their clients and patients get PAH. So they had someone ready to go. However, 24 hours before Evangelista's surgery, Zeltic got in touch with her and tried to make her sign a confidentiality agreement, basically saying that she can't talk about it. She will relinquish Zeltic of any responsibility for this. And if she signs that, they will pay for it. If not, she's on her own. In my opinion, rightfully so, Evangelista refused to sign this. Because once you sign that, there's kind of no going back. And if the surgery doesn't go well, there's not a lot more you can do. And by now, it was 24 hours before the appointment. You couldn't cancel the appointment. She's financially obligated to have this appointment. So she had the surgery, she went through with it. However, it was unsuccessful. She underwent even more surgery in 2017. The same thing, again, unsuccessful. Now all she's left with is keloid scarring. She's left in pain after every single surgery. She has to wear compression suits. She can't go out in public. This is years, years and years and years that she's been going through these corrective surgeries, and none of it's working. None of it's working. I would feel so defeated by now. And obviously she did, she says herself. Long story short, this forced Linda Evangelista out of work. In her own words, she called herself disfigured. And I guess when you kind of see what happened, for someone whose job, whose life and career is to be a model, and you look a certain way, and you're known for a certain look, I guess you could call yourself disfigured. I mean, you know, obviously not to minimize anything she went through, but when you look at her, you know, when the paparazzi kind of caught her during this time, she doesn't look disfigured. She looks like your average everyday woman. But she wasn't seen for years. She wouldn't even leave the house. And, you know, so much so that people were actually contacting her social media saying that they worried about her. She actually had to take to her own Instagram account and post this. She says, "Today I took a big step towards righting a wrong that I have suffered and kept to myself for over 5 years. To my followers who have wondered why I have not been working while my peers' careers have been thriving, the reason is that I was brutally disfigured by Zeltic's Cool Sculpting procedure, which is the opposite of what it promised. It increased, not decreased, my fat cells and left me permanently deformed. Even after undergoing two painful, unsuccessful corrective surgeries, I've been left, as the media has described, unrecognizable." She says that PHA has not only destroyed her livelihood, has sent her into a cycle of deep depression, profound sadness, and the lowest steps of self-loathing. "In the process, I have become a recluse. With this lawsuit, I am moving forward to rid myself of my shame and going public with my story. I'm so tired of living this way. I would like to walk out my door with my head held high despite not looking like myself anymore." That's got to be hard. No matter what happens, looking at yourself and not recognizing yourself in the mirror has got to be so, so difficult. She actually lost brand details. She lost her reputation, you know, as one of the most photographed women, constantly working. And before her surgery, she actually became the vice president of a skincare brand called Eraser, but couldn't be the face of the brand or make any public appearance or use her name and iconness to help promote the brand that she was vice president of. She was losing a shit ton of money, not to mention the emotional and mental distress that she was going through, as we heard claiming that she developed severe social anxiety and agoraphobia. So yeah, asking for $50 million in damages for, you know, lost work, work that she potentially had missed out on, public appearances, attorney fees, makes sense to me. You know, this is someone whose life revolves even around being out in public and being seen and being known to look a certain way. Does that say a lot about society? Of course, but you know, the fact is that's her job. Next up, I go in with my moisturizer. This is the Make Succulent Skin Gel Cream. They describe this as a serum weight moisturizer. And this is so good. You know, when you have your favorites, then you just kind of forget about them, then you rediscover them and you're like, oh my God, I actually love this. This is one of those. This is such a nice lightweight, deeply hydrating, moisturizing moisturizer that just feels so good for my combination skin. Hydrates in all the right parts, moisturizes in all the right parts, is light where it needs to be, but is nourishing and moisturizing enough where it needs to be too. And guess what? She won! She won this court case. I don't really think Zeltic have a leg to stand on really with this. So the lawsuit was filed in September of 2021, and by July-ish of 2022, the lawsuit was settled, and she posted this on her Instagram. She said, "I'm pleased to have settled the Cool Sculpting case. I look forward to the next chapter of my life with friends and family, and I'm happy to put this matter behind me. I'm truly grateful for the support I've received from those who have reached out. And since this post, she's been back to work. Her first campaign actually after this last year was with Fendi, where she looks stunning, stunning. She's been back on the cover of Vogue, been doing interviews openly about this whole experience, as I mentioned with People magazine, and generally being back to the activist and icon she always has been. Now, Zeltik really kind of kept surprisingly quiet throughout all this. You know, usually they make at least a halfway statement to be like, oh, you know, just kind of sticking up for themselves. Like, you know, they usually blame the customer. Like, you know, had they read the instructions, she would have been fine, kind of thing. But they didn't really make a statement until everything was kind of settled, until the settlement came out. And it was kind of just like an advert for Cool Sculpting. I don't know, it was really weird. Let me read it to you. In this statement, the only statement they made to Vogue, Zeltik said, "We are pleased to have resolved this matter with Miss Evangelista. Our focus continues to be on empowering confidence by providing safe, reliable aesthetics, products and services backed by science. Cool Sculpting is an FDA-cleared, non-invasive treatment for visible fat bulges in 9 areas of the body." That's weird. No, that's kind of weird. They're like, oh, everything's fine, but also remember what Cool Sculpting is good for, despite this lady being disfigured from it. I'm going to finish on Bondi Sands Sunny Days Hydrating SPF 50 Moisturizer. This is one of the only tinted moisturizers that my skin can actually get away without my skin going gray or white. I'm gonna build this up, by the way. I don't think we need to boycott this brand, you know, and everyone shouldn't have to be like scared of things like this, because as they mention, very rarely things do go wrong with these things. And as long as you're sufficiently warned, which Miss Evangelista wasn't, Mrs. I don't know the difference between those, to be honest with you. That's a risk you take when you do stuff like this, you know? We have a risk of choking every time you eat. I know that's a fair comparison. But, you know, it should have been properly described to her what could go wrong and what that actually means, and not just, oh, you might get a little bit fatter instead. I do think they dealt with it really poorly, like really poorly. Like the way they were like, oh, we'll pay for it, but you can't say anything bad about us, is kind of like, you know, expected from a brand, to be honest with you, from a business. A lot of people, industry professionals, are actually questioning, you know, whether a lot more people are actually suffering from PAH after Cool Sculpting than the Cool Sculpting brand kind of leads them to believe. They're kind of saying that they do feel it's more than 1% of patients being diagnosed with PAH after Cool Sculpting. But a New York Times examination, drawing on internal documents, lawsuits, medical studies, and interviews, indicates that the risk to patients may be considerably higher than that 1 in 3,000. Oh, you know what? Actually, this moisturizer, this sunscreen is now peeling all over my face. Look at that. That's terrible. Oh, I was happy with that one for a bit. I'm gonna go wash my face again. The New York Times found that they were actually restricting patients from talking about the problems that they suffered from after their Cool Sculpting experience, and that they may have actually at one point stopped reporting the side effects altogether to the FDA, with doctors being interviewed by the Times saying that the estimate of the risk was sharply lower than what they had observed in their own practices, saying the PAH is likely being underreported and misdiagnosed. And you know, it's sad but unsurprisingly that the media were extremely rough on Linda Evangelista. As they said, whenever they saw her in public, they'd photograph her and just talk about how unrecognizable this supermodel icon was. And you know, in a roundabout way, often just calling her fat and ugly. You know, people would pick pictures of her after what happened to her during her Cool Sculpting, next to pictures of her when she was in her 20s walking on a catwalk, you know. Like, this really unfair before and after. You know, it must have been really tough and mentally destroying, actually. However, last month, April of 2023, Evangelista announced that she's working on a book alongside her friend and photographer Steven Meisel. She said, "We've been making images together since we first met in 1987. Our book, Linda Evangelista, photographed by Steven Meisel, is a celebration..." Meisel? "A celebration of our friendship and an expression of our gratitude for the lives and careers we've been given." I just want to finish on that this wasn't the only time that this has happened, but she is one of the only people to speak publicly about this. But also, this happens to 40-year-old Gina Diadario, who, after Cool Sculpting, developed a mass on her stomach. She says that she was diagnosed with PAH in 2022. She's had multiple surgeries, including a tummy tuck and liposuction, and may need more. She was also offered $10,000 to help cover the costs, but yet again, contingent on her signing a confidentiality agreement, of which she declined. I'll finish on this statement by Dario. I'm sorry, I have no idea how to pronounce that. She said, I wish I loved my body back then, referring to a time before she had Cool Sculpting. To go back to that day, I wish I could, because I would never have gotten it done. It goes all over my facial. I have to go wash my face. Shit. So listen, let me know if you've ever considered having this done, if you've ever had anything like this done. Let me know in the comments down below. You can watch the full When Beauty Turns Ugly playlist here. Some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.